Once you've saved your video, you can view them in the review section. Here you'll see all of the videos that you have recorded, and by pressing on the video, it takes you through to the timeline of events that you recorded, and simply by pressing on the appropriate subtag, you can jump to that moment and play it back and hear what was being said at the time. You can make notes, and as soon as you've added a note, you can see that the notepad has turned red for that particular tag to identify that there has been something written here. We can also click on the folders to group the tags. This shows the greens for positives, amber for questions, and red for areas for development. Clicking on the info simply gives you the pre-record and the post-record data. While clicking on the statistics, it'll show the focus, giving a breakdown of the focus on the teacher, pupils working independently and pupils working as a group or as a whole class. The graph shows a representation of areas of strength and for development, and the engagement curve shows where engagement changed during the lesson, identifying key moments in time where you might like to go back and reflect on why engagement increased or decreased. Uploading the video to your secure online portal is very easy. Simply press the Upload to Cloud button on the right. It'll confirm that you want to upload this. Say yes, and the upload will begin, providing you're connected to a Wi-Fi network. On average, it takes about 1 to 2 minutes to upload an hour's worth of video. Once the video has been uploaded to the portal, you can delete the video from the iPad, saving memory space. Don't forget, if you're sharing the iPad, you need to log out now and encourage the next person to make sure that they log in to their account.